हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर एम्बिशियस स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय प्रैक्टिकल इंग्लिश चैनल व्हेयर वी विल लर्न अबाउट डायरी एंट्री राइटिंग पार्ट। बिफोर गोइंग टू द डायरी एंट्री आई वुड लाइक टू से समथिंग अबाउट योर लाइफ। दैट मीन्स व्हेन you are doing something, at that time you are becoming happy, sometimes you are becoming sad, sometimes you are becoming angry. Why? Because it is the expression of feelings, emotions, reactions or opinions. But sometimes if you are very sad, at that time you are not able to express these things to anyone. It may be your friend, it may be your parents, it may be your teacher, but there is someone with you to whom you are speaking. That is, who is that? Can anybody? Who is that? That is diary. That means if you have the habit of diary writing, then you can know. If you don't have the habit of diary writing, then you will not able to understand, but you will understand your emotions, feelings, opinions and reactions. But to express that, diary is required. Where no one is there, only your diary is with you. So, today's chapter is diary entry. That means it is a writing part. Clear? Diary entry. Before going to diary entry means there is a reality. If you are really writing a diary entry before going to the bed, then it is a good habit. If you are not practicing the habit of writing diary, then for the sake of examination, if you are writing, that is the different thing. So, today we will learn what is diary entry. But sometimes what happens, my dear students, please remember, always you are looking at the question, we are reading the question, we are reading the diary entry. But while we are writing, we are doing a blunder, we are doing a mistake. That means we are sometimes we are writing like this. This is the mistake. So, D-I-A-R-Y, diary. But here it is written D-A-I-R-Y. It is a diary. The meaning is different. Here diary means what you are writing. But diary means dairy milk, what you are telling. Dairy products. Okay. Sometimes spelling error. You are committing spelling error. So, be care. Be cautious. Write, try to write this. This is not so. I have mentioned it is a mistake. Some I have observed many more students are writing the spelling error D-A-I-R-Y. Sometimes it skips from your mind. You are thinking that it is diary, but it is not diary, it is dairy. Dairy milk. Have you written dairy milk? Okay, it is a diary. We have to write the diary. Now we will know what is diary. What happens there? That means Own memoir means it is the personal thing you have to keep. You have to record the personal thing in it. Okay, that is own memoir. Okay, then what it gives? Now gives a glimpse of past incidents. What happens to you yesterday? What happened today? What happened morning to evening or morning before going to bed? What happened? What you are recording on a paper, on a diary, that is known as diary. That means it gives the past incident. Clear? Please remember. Okay, what develops? What is being developed? What is being developed if we are writing a diary entry? If we have the practice of writing diary entry, what happens? That means it tests. That means our creativity, our imagination, our expression develops. It is the benefit we are getting. If you are writing daily, that means these three things, your creativity will be developed, your imagination power will develop, and expression power will also be fluent, right? So, it is also. And also, it is one kind of informal writing, no formal way, informal. I am very sad, I'm very happy, I'm very angry. That means what you want. You want to focus your emotion. That means always write in informal way about the diary. Then true in nature. Really, this is the basic thing, true in nature. That means today what happened from morning, early morning to 6 o'clock to night 8 p.m. What the incident happened in your life, that thing you are going to record in your diary. That is a true thing or false? Is it true or false? Are you going to write in false thing about you? No. So true thing, that means true in nature. There is no wrong. Everyone will accept it, true in nature. So diary is true in nature. Then write in one paragraph or two. At least, if I don't know how many incidents have been occurring, are being occurring in your life. That means while you are going to record it, at least write in one paragraph, or if it becomes more, then write in at least two paragraphs. But one paragraph for the point of examination, one paragraph is sufficient. Okay? Then how to write a diary entry? Now the question arises, we know about what is diary, we know about the difference between D-I-A-R-Y and D-A-I-R-Y. It is dairy, it is diary. Then about diary, you know. Now how to write a diary entry? That means for the examination sake, how will you write the end? How will we write the diary entry? That means it will help a lot. That means date, day, time. That means the left side, what you will do, suppose this is the paper, first date, then come to day, then come to time. Date, date, time. That means especially preferable PM. PM means post-meridian. That means post-meridian. Post-meridian. That means you are going to write in night time, evening time, right time before going to board. So preferable PM. Don't write AM while you are writing diary. Okay. First you will write the date, then you will day, which day, then time. Okay. Heading is completely optional. Many more students are getting confusion. Sir, I have seen in that book, in that reference book, sir, heading is given. And some students are writing, sir, no headings is given. Is it required? Dear beta, if the incident you are focusing it, one incident, that means you can write a heading. If not, no problem. That means heading is completely optional. It depends upon you. If you write, no more mark will be given. If you don't write, no mark will be cut. Okay? So the heading is completely optional. It's your choice. But I suggest that don't write the headings. Okay? Okay. Then, dear diary or hello diary. It is while you are going to write your friend, a dear Animus, dear Amles, dear Amlan, like that you are writing. So you can write dear diary. Dear diary, like that, dear diary, or hello diary. You can write dear diary or hello diary. Okay, then what is the another thing? Write in first person. Here, while your diary entry, already I have told you, it is the personal thing, your thing. So always start with what I have already told you, first person. First person means I or we. If you are alone, you write I. If you are more, then you can use we. I or we. Or I will tell about this am or are. We are. Okay, I will tell. Then contents in chronological order. Contents. Suppose in one day what happened, I don't know. Suppose you went to the hospital in bad mood, but when you are returning to your home, you are in a good mood. But in between that, what happened? You know, I don't know. Why? That means your bad mood, how it turned into good mood. That the feelings, that the expression, you will write contents. What the contents have happened? That means you will write in chronological order. That means start with events. After dear diary, that means I am very happy. Today I am very happy. I went to hospital. When I went to hospital, I was very sad. But when I returned, I became happy. What is the thing happened? You have to describe. You start with the events. Okay? Then in a diary, what you are expressing? Now you are expressing your feelings. You are expressing no content. You are not your feelings, happy mood, angry mood, or sorrow mood. You are expressing your feelings. You are expressing your emotions. You are expressing your reactions. You are expressing your opinions. These things are you are expressing. Okay? For the particular day. Please remember. That means you are not writing the diary for 3 or 4 or 5 days at a time. What happened today? Today night you are going to write it. Okay? That means it indicates feelings, emotions, reactions or opinions. Now, here I can say one thing. That means feeling means these are the happy feelings. Happy feelings, delighted, cheerful, joyful, in high spirit, overjoyed, pleased, glad. These are the happy feelings. Okay, but here sorrow feelings, joyless, regretful, sorrowful, unhappy, displeased, depressed. These are the, that means if your event is sorrowful, then you can use these words. If your emotions are very happy, that means you can use these words. But where sometimes you are getting angry, you are becoming angry, that means angry time you are becoming furious, annoyed, angry, you can also use these words. Then in your diary entry, these feelings should be reflected. Okay, then while writing the diary entry, always use the past simple. Past simple. Already I have taught you the present simple. Later on I will go to the past simple. Formula is the same, but the verb pattern will be changed. Okay, but always use past simple. Don't use present because it is the past thing. These incidents have occurred. Okay, it should be written on one page. My dear students, please remember, sometimes while we are getting the answer paper in the examination hall, sometimes while we are going to start the diary entry, in one page half, in another page half. If page permits like that, you are writing like that. But please remember, try to write the diary entry in one page. That means it should not be divided into two pages. It will be better. Okay. Then use the contracted form. I have already told you, here I told that use first person, you are always first person, but these are the contracted form. I'd means I had, or I would, that means contracted form. I am, I apostrophe am, contracted form. If you are using I am, I had, or I would, like that, that means contracted form, in written form you can use it. Then, while, that means your content will be there. In the content, what you will express your feelings in form of incident, what happened to you, that means you will describe the incidents. Okay, while you are going to conclude it, that means at that time you can write by, you can suppose it is completed, in the left side you can write by, or you can write good night. You can write good night, no problem. Also, you can write, I wait a new day tomorrow, you can write. Or also, you can write, I will share you my experience with you tomorrow. That means today's work is completed. You have completed your work today. So, for tomorrow, we are going to meet. That means you are going to meet with a diary. That means I will share you my experience with you tomorrow. It is the ending or conclusion line. Then after that, what will be signature? Here, that means you know date, time, dear diary, feelings and content. Then ending line means bye or good night, or I wait a new day tomorrow, I will share my experience with you tomorrow. After that, what will be your signature? Will be here. Your signature will be here. Don't like this, don't write signature, don't write. You will give your signature. Suppose Aman. You are on, okay, signature. But sometimes what happens, students are also asking these two things. Sir, is box required? For a diary entry, is box required? As like as a notice, we are requiring a box. Is it box required? My dear students, please remember, box doesn't require. Box doesn't require. If anyone by mistakenly keeps it in a box, still then no mark will be deducted. But avoid though, keep it in a box. Okay, avoid these things. Okay, no box is required. Then last thing is word limit as per instruction. What the instruction is given, especially 80 to 100 words, the instruction coming, that means you have to strictly obey the word limit. If you obey these things, if you know what is the main thing, you have to remember this or this where you are doing the mistake, then it should be kept in your mind what is diary. And you should know the tips, what is written the tips, and also you know that what are the feelings words, that means happy feelings, sorrow feelings, the angry mood feelings, these are the words you have to use. Then here some contents are given, some tips are given, you read it and attend the class clearly and try to understand, accordingly you go. Then word limit, you know, as per the instruction, right? Now, my dear students, if you understood this, now I think you will be able to write a diary entry properly. So, the homework is given. So, listen, what is the homework given? Now, describe in a form of diary entry in about 80 to 100 words. See, 100 words given, 80 to 100 words. About the pandemic, the content is what is that? The pandemic COVID-19, which became the root cause of stopping offline class. Now, the pandemic situation has stopped your offline class. But you are doing all the classes in online. What you are missing and what you are getting? Your feelings, your expression, that means COVID is the root cause of stopping offline class. Now, in your school, now express your feelings. You are happy mood, or you are in joy mood, or you are in sorrow mood, or you are in angry mood, or no mood is there. You will express your feelings in the form of diary. And please remember, you are Radha. If you are a girl, you are Radha. And if you are a boy, you are Radhesham. That means here I have told you date, day, time, dear diary, write in first person, already I have told you, start with, then content, after content, strictly obey the word limit and follow these rules. Last, you can write bye, good night, I wait a new day tomorrow, or I will say you by experience with you tomorrow. Then signature. Signature means if you are a girl, you can write Radha. If you are a boy, you can write Radhesham. Radhesham. And already I have told you, no need to keep it in a box. No need to keep it in a box. If you understood, I think you would be able to complete this homework. Okay, beta? Okay, is there any problem? No problem? If you have any problem, you comment in the comment box. Thank you, beta. Bye. Keep it up.